press the bell icon on the YouTube app and never miss another update.
Hello all, how are you? I hope that all are doing good. So today I am here with you with the new lesson. The name of the lesson is The Necklace. The Necklace, this lesson, the story is written by the writer called Guidi Maupassant. Okay, so here little bit, the name is a little bit different here. Okay, like something like strange. So here the writer is Guidi Maupassant. Okay, and this writer was born on 5th of August in 1850, okay, and in France. So he is also one of the French author, okay, a famous French author, and he written so many of short stories. Some of the short stories are here, The Necklace, okay, that is also one of the short story. So then A Woman's Life, then The Private Affairs of Belle Aimée. So these are the works of Guidi Maupassant. So let's come to about the lesson, that is The Necklace. Here, this lesson, this story is about woman, okay, the name of the woman is Matilda. Okay, here I have written some of the characters on the board. So that is Matilda, and after the marriage, she become that Madame Loisel. Okay, so Madame Loisel, here is Mr. Loisel. Mr. Loisel, he is a husband of Madame Loisel, that is Matilda. Then she, here is the Madame Forestier, so she is a friend of Matilda. Okay, so here I wanted to introduce about this characters. Okay, so these are about the characters of this lesson, that is the story. Okay, so once again I am repeating, Matilda, she is the main character, the major character of the story. The next character is the Mr. Loisel, so he is a husband of a Matilda. Then Madame Forestier, so she is also a friend of Matilda. So the story revolves around Matilda. Matilda, she's a woman, ambitious woman, okay, where she deserves more than what she had in her life, okay, because always she is expecting more than what she has, okay, because she belongs to a clerk family, middle class family. So who her father is working in a some of the office work, okay, that is a clerical job. So in that job, the income source is limited, okay, but Matilda's the demands, her expectation from the life is more than that, okay. So here the story revolves around Matilda and her husband. Okay, so how these two characters are suffered because of the unexpected thing what they were expecting from the life. Okay, so not only I'm not saying about your husband, but the major character which gives a important message, that is the Matilda. So because of her, so her husband is also sufferer. Okay, so why? Because she has not accepted the life what she has, because she needs more than that. Okay, so here in this lesson, we will learn some of the important message, so which you people also remember till you are lifelong. Okay, so this is not only for a few years or after some years, not like that. So throughout your life, you will be remember this as a moral of the life. Okay, so this is also called as a life lesson. Okay, so this is not only a syllabus of your class, this is also one of the moral of a life. Okay, so let's see about this lesson. Matilda is invited to a grand party. She has a beautiful dress but no jewelry. She borrows a necklace from a friend and loses it. What happens then? Okay, so here Matilda, so once she has been invited for a party, that is the grand party, and she has a beautiful dress, but she is expecting the jewelry, and then she has borrowed that jewelry from her friend called Madame Frostier. So then she has lost it. So then what happened to that story? Okay, what happened to the Matilda and then her husband? Let's see in this lesson. Are these two people lost a necklace, or they have find out some other way? Okay, so which the friend, because the necklace is they have borrowed from a friend. So how they can get back to give back that necklace to her friend. Okay, let's see here. Here, I'm going to read this lesson first. Okay, so after the paragraph, then I will explain this one. Okay, she was one of those pretty young ladies born as if through an error of destiny into a family of clerks. She had no dowry, no hopes, no meaning, no means of becoming known, loved and married by a man either rich or distinguished. And she allowed herself to marry a petty clerk in the office of the Board of Education. She was simple, but she was unhappy. So here she refers to Madhilta. Okay, so here Madhilta, she is one of the pretty women. Okay, and then a young lady. Okay, so among the young ladies, she is also one of the pretty young lady. Then she was born an error of destiny. By mistakenly, she has born in the middle class family. That is called error of destiny. Okay, then into a family of clerks. So family of clerks where they were not afford the luxurious life because their income is very limited. So that's why they are living in a limited wants, and the wants are not more. Okay, so in that she has to live. She had no dowry, no hopes, no means of becoming known, loved or married by an either rich or distinguished. Because she belongs to a middle class family, so there is no dowry and there is no hopes to fulfill the money which the rich people can offer that. And then the means of being known, okay, and then loved by any rich person and then married to any of the rich man. So they don't have the dowry, there is no hopes and there is no enough money, or she is not being loved with any of the rich men. Okay, rich man to get married with. Okay, then, and she allowed herself to marry a petty clerk in the office of the Board of Education. So she gets married to a gentleman, the gentleman who is working in a Board of Education as a clerk. Okay, as a clerk, she get married. She was a simple, but she was unhappy. So she was, after her marriage, she is living a simple life, but she is unhappy. Okay, but her husband, he is fulfilling her whatever her demands are. Okay, whatever her needs, demands, everything, he is fulfilling it. But then also she is unhappy. Okay, this is. I hope that you have understood what is the character of Madhilta. She is an ambitious woman. She is expecting more than that, whatever she has in her life. Okay, and she is not happy in her married life because of she wanted to lead a luxurious life. Because she is a very attracted woman and she has born as a error. Mistakenly, she has born in the family of a middle class. Okay, so like this is the first paragraph. Let's move to the further paragraph. She suffered incessantly, feeling herself born for all delicacies and luxurious. She suffered from a poverty of her apartment, the shabby walls and worn chairs. All these things tortured and angered her. So she suffered incessantly, means continuously she is suffering. So why? Feeling herself born for all delicacies and luxurious. So always she is feeling that she wanted to be born in the family of a luxurious life. Okay, so she has to lead a luxurious life where the rich people, they can afford it. So always she is in a sad, she is in depressed. Delicacies mean fineness, soft to fineness. So whatever the things were enjoying by the rich people, so she is also expecting from her life. Okay, and then she suffered from the poverty of her apartment. Apartment means, you know, the apartments, it is common in the metropolitan cities. Okay, that is a flat. They had rent their apartment in a flat. Okay, in an apartment as a flat, they are living there. Then there she is suffering a lot because of the poverty. She is not that poor, but actually the condition, whatever she has, so it seems to her it is a poor. Okay, then the shabby walls and the worn chairs. So actually they can't repair the walls and they can't maintain the flat what they are expecting. So that's why, because it's a limited income of her husband, So that's why they can't provide all those things. So here he's they are describing about a apartment, that is the flat where she is living. That is shabby walls. Shabby walls means dirty walls. Okay. So where it is not plastered for a long time, it is not painted for a long time. So that is called as a shabby walls. And then worn chairs means broken chairs. The chairs are not well maintained. Okay. So it was broken. All these things tortured and angered her. So when she looked into her flat, in her wherever she is living, so whenever she looks the walls and broken chairs and furniture, she feels like angered, she feels frustrated. Okay, so this is, and it is like a torturing to her. Then when she seated herself for dinner opposite her husband, who uncovered the tureen with the delight air, saying, "Oh, the good pot pie, I know nothing better than that." She would think of elegant dinners of shining silver, and she thought of the exquisite food served in marvelous dishes. She had neither frocks nor jewels, nothing, and she loved only those things. So here in this paragraph, it is describing the condition of her husband and also Marilta. So how, like when she seated herself once while they both are having a dinner, so they are sitting opposite her husband. So then she has uncovered the tureen. Tureen means it's a serving bowl. So she was uncovered it. So then it was a soup in that. And then the husband was appreciating that whatever the dinner she has served on a table. That, so he was given the exclamation with the happiness that, oh, the good pot pie. So he feels very happy. So when he was looked into the soup, that is the dinner, whatever she has served, "I know nothing better than that," he was appreciated. So more than that, I am not expecting that. So it is one of the important tastier food. So he said, she would think of elegant dinners, but rather than she is happy with the what the husband is appreciating for her preparing a dinner, she is feeling about the dinner which is elegant. Elegant means gracefully. Okay, all the table which should be decorated with all the food items, the different types of food items on the table which is decorated. Okay, so like that she is expecting. Then, and shining silver means the plates and the spoons, it was made from the silver metal. Okay, so the dinner should be served in that silver plates. So she is expecting that. She is thinking that one also. She thought of the exquisite food served in marvelous. Okay, means it is a wonderful food arrangement. It is on the table. She is always being thinking of that food. Okay, where it was supplied in the rich people family. Okay, so how that you are understanding the character of Marilta. And then dishes, she had neither frocks nor jewels. Okay, so here it says that she neither had a good dresses and not the jewelries. Okay, and nothing, she loved only those things. But she is loving those things only. Okay, whatever, the frocks and the jewelries, she is lacking more that. She is fond of those things. Okay, this is about the Marilta. Then she had a rich friend, a schoolmate at the convent, who she did not like to visit. She suffered so much. When she returned, she wept for whole days from despair and disappointed. Okay, so when she was in the school, she had a rich friend. Okay, rich friend, and she was also married, and then she was never being visited to her home. So whose home? That rich friend home. So whenever she was visit to her home, she feels disappointed, she feels sad. So whenever she returned from her home, she always complained about her destiny. Okay, so like this. One evening, her husband returned elated, bearing in his hand a large envelope. Okay, so one evening, her husband returned from office with holding a large envelope with the happily he came to home. Okay, that is, then he said, here's something for you. So he said that. So with them, surprisingly, so he was happy when he is telling to her wife that he has something to give her. Then she quickly drew out a printed card on which were inscribed these words. So there was a large envelope. She was quickly took the card and she was opened that envelope. Okay. So in that there was a card. So what it is written? The Minister of Public Instruction and Madam George Reponier asked the honor of Madam Lossell's company Monday evening, January 18, at the minister's residence. So this is the invitation. Okay, invitation given by the head of the office where the Mr. Lossell was working. Okay, so he is being invited for a minister's residence for a occasion. Okay, there was a party, that is the grand party. So both of them, the husband and wife, they were invited for that party. So that is on January 18th. Okay, so on Monday. Instead of being delighted as her husband had hoped, she threw the invitation spitefully upon the table, murmuring, "What do you suppose I want with that?" See how rudely she is telling to her husband. Instead of being happy, so the way the husband is, he is giving that card to her wife, instead of being happy with that, whatever he has brought, she was spitefully, spitefully means she was with the hatredness, she was throw that card on the table, okay? And she was murmuring with a low sound, she is telling something. So what it is, what do you suppose I want that? So what you are supposing, what I want to do there? Okay, so like that, she said with a whispering voice. "But my dearie, I thought it would make you happy." But husband is politely, he is saying to the wife, "So why, dear, what happened to you? So I thought that this party give you happiness. So always you are being, you always wanted to go to that kind of a party. So that's why I'm giving to you. Okay, that gives a happiness to you. Then you never go out, and this is an occasion and a fine one." So always she is in this home and she feels sad and she feels despair. So that's why her husband thought of that. So at least if she could come with him, then she feels happy. And always she is expecting to go for that kind of an occasion. Okay, so then everybody wishes one, and it is very select. Now husband is saying again, he is just convincing her that by telling again and again. So like everybody wishing that to go to that occasion, but only few people were selected to go for a party. Okay, not many given to employees. Only few employees are selected for that party. Then you will see the whole official world there. So whole official world means, so it's all the official people who are working in that office. So all the people were present there. So when you look at them, you feel happy there. So her husband is convincing her. She looked at him with an irritated eye and declared impatiently, "What do you suppose I have to wear to such a thing as that?" So she was irritated. With the very irritated eye, with the anger eye, she was looked at husband, okay? And then she said, "What do you suppose I have to wear?" So wear means she's just expecting the good dress and jewelries, okay? So this is the meaning of this attitude. So this is the meaning of the attitude of Madilta. So like that, she is showing her husband, that is the anger, that she is not having more jewelries and not having the good fine dresses, okay? She is complaining indirectly. Then he had not thought of that. He stammered, "Why the dress you wear when we go to the theater?" So then he had thought, suddenly he just started thinking about that. The Mr. Lossell, he started thinking about that, why she is telling about the dress. Then stammering, with the stammering, because he got nervous. Okay, then again he says here, "Why the dress you wear when you go to the theater?" So when you are going to theater, you are wearing the kind of a dress. So why don't you try for that party? So he is saying that with a polite voice. Then, "It seems very pretty to you, to me." Okay, "It seems very pretty to me." So when you wear that dress, so you are looking very pretty to me. He was silent, stupefied in dismay at the sight of his wife weeping. Okay, stupefied means stunned. So he was shocked. Then dismay. Dismay means he is also shocked and stunned. Then, so he was shocked and stunned. The Mr. Lossell, he was shocked and stunned by seeing that her wife is weeping. Okay, her wife is weeping, she is crying. Then again, he is giving that answer. He stammered, "What is the matter? What is the matter?" So again, he is asking question to Matilda with the stammering words. By violent effort, she had controlled her vexation and responded in a calm voice, weeping her moist cheeks. "Nothing, only I have no dress. Consequently, I cannot go to the affair. Give your card to some colleague whose wife is better fitted out than I." Okay. So in this paragraph, Madilta violently said to her husband, okay, that is in a strong voice, she said that. Then she has controlled herself, she has controlled her weeping, then controlled her emotions. Again, then she said that with a calm voice. So no, nothing, no matter. She weeps, she was wiped the tears on her cheeks. Then again, she said that, "Nothing, I have no dress. So what is the matter? Why I'm crying? Because I don't have a dress. Then, and consequently, I cannot go to the affair." Affair means it's about party. So I didn't have that kind of a dress which is suited for that party. So I am not going to that party. Then, give your card to some colleagues. So instead of saying that, again she said that, so you can give that card to your colleagues, means which is working in his office, okay? So that is the employee. So those wives, your colleagues' wives, they have a good dresses, they have a jewelries, they can be good for that party. So you just hand over those card to your colleagues, other colleagues, okay? She has rejected it. She is not accepted to go for a party because of the jewelries and dresses. Then he was grieved but answered, "Let us see, Marilta, how much would suitable costume cost?" Suitable costume cost something that would serve for other occasions, something very simple. Okay, then he understood that. So the wife of his, so she is expecting something. So she is expecting the dresses, and only the dress, not jewelry. Only dress. So then he asked that, so how much cost of that dress? Okay, so don't worry, he will afford it. So then he said it, and then you can have to purchase the dress which you can wear it to the any other occasions, which is simple one. Then she reflected for some seconds thinking. She was reflected means she was thought of that, okay, about the dress. And she was thinking for a few seconds. So far, why she is thinking here? Thinking of a sum that she could ask for without bringing with in an immediate refusal and a frightened exclamation from the economical clerk. Okay, she was accepting. She was accepting the what the husband is offering for her. Okay, and then again she is thinking about. So what about the economical the condition of the husband? So she has to look over that. Okay, she is thinking for a while. So she don't want to lose this chance. So what the husband is offering for her? So she is he is asking the cost of the dress. So that one, and also she is offering for the. If she says the cost which is the husband is not offering it, he is not afford it, so then she is frightened about that. Because of that, she is thinking. Okay, so suddenly she is not responded to her question. Finally, she said in a hesitated voice with the unsure voice, she said, "I cannot tell exactly, but it seems to me that 400 francs ought to cover it." Okay, so unsure, she is not sure here. So then with the low voice, she has said that, "I cannot tell exactly. I don't know what is the exact price of the dress." But she has given the round figure of the costume of a dress, that is 400 francs. 400 francs. Francs means which is French currency, okay? So that is called francs. Francs. Out to cover it, okay? So she needs 400 francs to get some good dress, okay? To get a good dress, she needs the 400 francs. He turned little pale. So when he heard that the price of the dress, then he was pale. Pale means his the face color got the face color of the Mr. or Lozelle was colorless. Okay, for he had served just his summer to buy a gun that he might be able to join some hunting parties the next summer with some friends who went to shoot larks on Sunday. So he has arranged some of the amount, that is 400 francs, because so when the summer season comes, so he has to gather with his friends for a hunting party. Okay, hunting party, so on every Sunday, so where he was to shoot the larks means birds. Okay, so this one he was kept that amount for that what he was expected. Nevertheless, he answered, very well, I will give you 400 francs, but try to have a pretty dress. Okay, then he was agreed that he will give her that 500 francs, but she has to get a good dress. Okay, so like that, husband is all the things whatever she is demanding, he is fulfilling. Although he is not bothering about what is his wishing. Okay, he planned for something with his friends. Okay, but now he cancelled it, and then now he is accepting the words of wife, that is Marilda. Okay, so now this is about the story of a husband and wife, how these people are having a problem, okay, with the financial situation. So then let's move to the further paragraph. So now the day of the ball approached, and Madame Lozelle seemed sad, disturbed, anxious. Okay, ball means it's a party, the grand party they were invited for. Okay, so it was nearer. So the ball party, it was nearer. Again, the Madame Lozelle was sad and disturbed, and then she feels anxiety. Okay, anxious. Nevertheless, her dress was nearly ready. So she has purchased dress. Okay, it was ready now. Her husband said to her one evening, "What's the matter with you? You have acted strangely for 2 or 3 days." Okay, because she feels very sad, and again she feels like anxious. Then again one of the evening, the husband is asked to her that why she feels sad. What's the matter? So since from 2 to 3 days you are not in a good, okay, in a good mood, then again you are behaving very strangely. So what's the matter? Again he was asking a reason, and she responded. Now she has answered, "I am vexed not to have a jewel, nothing to adorn myself with. I shall have a such poverty-stricken look. I would prefer not to go to this party." Okay, so now she has responded, she has answered to her husband the question. So what she is annoyed because she don't have a jewelry. She doesn't have a jewelry and nothing adorn myself with. So there is nothing to decorate with herself. Okay, so except jewelry, so nothing is to be decorated. Only she had a dress here. "I shall have a such a poverty-stricken look." Without the jewelry, she would be look like a poverty-stricken look, means she would be look like a poor. She needs some jewelry here. "I would prefer not to go to this party." So yeah, so her husband has arranged the dress, but now she is expecting the jewelry. Okay, she needs jewelry to decorate herself, and she is giving a reason to her husband that she should not go to the party because she feels like she would be like a poor woman in between such a good ladies. Okay, so she was rejected again. He replied, "You can wear some natural flowers in this season. They look very chic." Okay, chic means elegant and fashionable. So her husband is again, he is giving the ideas. So better you can wear any flowers which is easily available in this season. Okay, so that is also very beautiful for on you. So you can wear it. So he said it. Okay, it is also looks very elegant, very fashionable and more stylish. So why don't you try it? So her husband has said like that. She was not convinced, but although whatever he says, she is not convinced. Okay, "No," she replied, "there is nothing more humiliated than to have a shabby air in the midst of rich women." Okay, so again she said, She was said no, she was rejected to go to the party. And she says here, it is like with the rich women, in between the rich women in that party. So I feel like a shabby air. Shabby air means it's like a dirty for me. Okay, so dirty for me to be in that group of a rich woman. So she feels uncomfortable. Indirectly she says that, says here, she feels uncomfortable with among the rich women. Okay, so if she visited to that party and she feels humiliated, insulted. Then her husband cried out, "How stupid we are. Go and find your friend, Madame Forrester, and ask her to lend your jewels." So again, her husband is trying to help her. Okay, so again he is giving her the idea that she had a friend. Okay, the friend is Madame Forrester. So why don't you go and she can borrow some of the jewelry from her, because she is a rich woman. Okay, she is a rich friend of her. Okay, then she's then he said like that. She uttered a cry of joy when she has listened the words of the husband. She feels happy, she feels delighted. Okay, then it's true. Then she has given the emotions like that, the feelings like this. It is true, she said, I had not thought of that. Yes, it is true that I have not thought of that. She can lend me some of the jewelry. Yeah. So then the next day she took herself to her friend's house and related her story of distress. So when she has listened that what the husband has said about the Madame Frostier, so then she was next day she visited to the friend's home. Okay, without delay she has visited to friend's home, and then she was tell the story of her whatever the distress she had. Madame Frostier went to her closet, took out a large jewel case, brought it, opened it, and said, "Choose, my dear." So when she has heard the story of a friend, that is Madilda's story, so suddenly Madame Frostier, she went near to the closet where she has kept all the jewelries and dresses, and then she has got the boxes where she has kept the jewelries and put it in front of the Madilda, and she said, "Choose, my dear, whichever you like, you can choose it." Okay, then she saw what a adorable friend she is. Okay, so she is very kindable and very kind, and she is helping to her friend. Okay, without any delay, without giving any reason, she is also helping her. She has trusted her. Okay, and then she saw at her first some bracelets, then collar of pearls, then a Venetian cross of gold, and jewels of admirable workmanship. Okay, so she saw in the boxes some different types of ornaments. The first she has observed that is bracelets. Okay, then she looked into the collar pearls, the necklace means which is made up with the pearls, so that one, and then the Venetian cross gold. Venetian cross gold means the design which is made from a Venice city. Okay, Venice city, that is the Venice style which is made from the Venice city. So Venice is a city. Okay, it is a name of a city. Then the next is, it's a gold one, and the next admirable workmanship, that is the next jewel is which is designed by the workmanship. Okay, it is crafted by the workmanship. So this one, all the jewelries she has kept in front of her. She tried the jewels before the glass. So one by one she is trying in front of the glass. Okay, hesitated but could neither decide to take them nor leave them. Okay, so whenever she has tried the jewelries one by one, she neither decided that which one she has to pick and which one she has to reject it. Okay, then she asked, have you nothing more? And again she asked that, so do you have more jewelries? Okay, then, why? Yes, look for yourself. I don't know what will please you. So you only look yourself. Okay, so then after, so this one was said by Madame Frostier. Okay, so she said that, so all the jewelries are kept here. See that which one you like it, which one you feel happy, so you can choose it. So then, suddenly she discovered in a black satin box, superb necklace of diamonds. So when she was looking into the other jewelry boxes, she was find out the satin box where there was the diamond necklace, which was sparkling, okay, which was sparkling in diamonds. It was a superb necklace. Her hands trembled. Her hands trembled as she took it out. Trembled means shake. So when she was taking it out from her hand was shaking because it is a diamond necklace. And she is expecting that kind of a necklace too in her life. But now it is there, okay. Then, and as she took it out, she placed it about her throat against her dress and was extra ecstatic. Okay, ecstatic means notable. So when she has took that necklace near to her throat, so then it was becomes very notable. Okay, notable. It looks very fine. Then she asked in a hesitated voice, full of anxiety, "Could you lend me this? Only this?" So when she has took near the throat to wear it, okay, so then she feels very amazed. She feels very happy. So then she asked that, "Could you lend me this?" So only this. So I want, she liked it. She liked that diamond necklace. Now she is asking to her friend that, "Could you lend me this necklace?" Okay, then now her friend says, "Why, yes, certainly." She is also accepting that. Yes, she is also ready to lend this diamond necklace. Okay, then she fell upon the neck of her friend, embraced her with passion, then went away with her treasure. Okay, then she fell, she feels very happy. She, Madhulika, is very precious now because so always she is complaining for such things. Now it is in her hand. She feels very, it like she got something like precious thing in her hand. Okay, she feels like treasury. Okay, that is the necklace. And now she feels very passionate about that necklace. And then she was went away from that, went away from friend house. Okay, so then the day of the ball arrived. Madame Lucelle was a great success. She was the prettiest of all, elegant, gracious, smiling and full of joy. So the ball is near. The ball is arrived means the party is near. Okay, then she was, Madame Lucelle was very great success. She was success because she is like a fulfill her ambition. She needs a good dress and she wants a jewelry. So everything, whatever she desired for, whatever she is longing for, it is there. And it looks like she has achieved the success in her life. Okay, then she was prettiest of all. So when the party was organized and she was visited there, then she feels like elegant, okay, and the more prettiest there. Then gracious, gracious means polite, elegant, very fine, looking very fine, and she have a high spirit. You know, the people when they what they were deserve and they feels very happy. So it looks on their face, they are like a blushing, is it? So they feel like they are at top of the world. So they achieve the success in their life. So she is also same thing. She is in a joy. She can't control herself. Okay, then smiling and full of joy. She is full of joy. She feels very happy. All the men noticed her, asked her name and wanted to be presented. Okay, so every man were noticed her because she feels very happy. She feels like she was the top of the world. Okay, and then everybody wanted to meet her. That is called presented her. Then she danced with enthusiasm, intoxicated with pleasure. She danced with enthusiasm, with a high spirit, with the most stylish. She was danced in that party and intoxicated to lose control of oneself. Intoxicated to lose the control of oneself when they have some alcohol, okay, when they have got more intoxicated in her body. So how it is? If some people were consumed more alcohol, so how they were? They lose their control. So she is also seems like that, okay? Thinking of nothing but all this admiration, this victory so complete and sweet for her heart. So it is like a victory for her. She has won something in her life, okay? And that, so whatever she has expected, it was like complete from bottom of her heart. She feels very delighted. She feels very happy, okay? Then, after that, she went home towards 4 o'clock in the morning. So in that party, she has enjoyed. She feels like high spirit in the air, and then she feels she was lost her control. Okay, she was very happy and delighted. And then they are reached their home at nearly 4 o'clock. Okay. Then in the morning, her husband had been half asleep in one of the little saloons since midnight. So in that party, her husband was half slept. There was a room in that party, so they were slept there, okay, in that room, in particular party. Then with three other gentlemen whose wives were enjoying themselves very much. So Madilda and other three wives, means the employees' wives, so they were also enjoying there. They are having a small get together there. Okay, they were having some discussions, and those people, they were sleeping in one of the room in that minister's residence. Okay, he threw around her shoulders the modest wraps they had carried, whose poverty clashed with the elegance of the ball costume. So he threw, means Mr. Lozell, he just covered her husband's shoulder with some of the wraps. Wraps means you can say the shrug, okay? So he wanted to cover with her shoulder with a shrug, but she was rejected because it is not look like the rich woman, okay? It is not look like a kind of a rich woman. So she feels insulted with those women. So that's why she was not wear that shrug. Then she wished to hurry away in order not to be noticed by the other women who were wrapping themselves in rich furs. So when she was rejected her husband, that she should not wrap herself, and she was ready to go away from there where the other women, rich women, they are wearing the good furs, shrugs over them, okay? So for that they could not caught them easily, so that's why she wanted to go away from that very hurriedly. Okay, then Lozell detained her means husband was asked her. Wait, said he, I am going to call a cab. So he was interrupted her because she is hurriedly, she wanted to go out from that minister's residence. So then he was said that, so wait, why you are going hurriedly? So he will call a cab, okay, taxi. Then, but she would not listen and descended the steps rapidly. Okay, she was not listening to her husband. She was going near to the steps very fastly. When they were in the streets, they found no carriage. They began to seek for one, hailing the coachman whom they saw at the distance. Okay, when they were moving towards their home on the streets, so there will be no carriage. No carriage means cart, means one who drives by the horse. So there were no carriages on the street. And then they are searching for one of the hailing. Hailing means calling. Okay, calling the coachman to saw the distance. Okay, far away from a little of distance, they could see that there was a coachman. Okay, which he is taking them for a ride. Then they walked along towards the river, hopeless and shivering. Okay, so then they were not seen any of the coachman or any cart. No carriages. So that's why they were walking near the river, and they were hopeless because they are not finding any cab or any carriages. So then they were shivering because of the cold. Finally, they found one of those old carriages that one sees in Paris after nightfall. Okay. So after, when they were walking on the streets, so then they were find out one of the old carriages which is old carriages they have got, which is in the Paris. So where they are roaming all over the night, so that kind of old carriages they have got. It took them as far as their door, and they went wearily up to their apartment. Wearily means tired. So that old carriages they took to their apartment. Okay, then they went to their apartment, that is the flat. It was all over for her. Now everything has finished, because whatever she was expecting, whatever she deserved, and whatever the way she wanted to look herself in that way, she was completed now. So she feels happy with that. Okay, so everything, it was end for her now. And on his part, he remembered that he would have to be at the office by 10 o'clock. So when they were reached to home, so her husband remembered that she has to leave to the office nearly 10 o'clock. At 10 o'clock, she has to go to the office. Then she removed the wraps from her shoulders, means she had removed the strap from her shoulders before the glass. So in front of the mirror, she started removing the straps for a final view of herself in her glory. So she wanted to look herself in the final image of her. So she wanted to look in herself into the mirror. Okay, so how she was looking glorious. Okay, that. And suddenly she uttered a cry. Her necklace was not around her neck. So when she was looking herself in a mirror, in front of mirror, she has observed that there is no necklace in her neck. Okay, now she was cried. She was shouting to her husband that. Okay, she was crying out and she was shouting at her husband. So this is the today's class. I'll continue this lesson in the next class. I hope that you are enjoyed and you are also understanding what are the circumstances she is having here. Okay, so this is the today's class. I will continue in the next class. All of you stay at home, keep learning. Thank you.